you so much for coming to House of Prayer this afternoon, to this House of Prayer session. Thank you for doing the Lord's work, for helping us be the people that God's called us to be a people of prayer. This is a special week, being Holy Week. We're setting it apart for the Lord, just to help us in preparing our hearts for what the Lord wants to do in us this weekend and our families this weekend. In here in this auditorium, we have prepared these six different stations that'll be available all week long. And so if you're joining us online, please come stop by the church throughout this week. For those that are here, even you can use House of Prayer sessions to walk through the six stations using this booklet. They're out in the lobby. Grab this booklet. And the whole heart in this is us preparing the ground of our hearts for what the Lord wants to do in us this weekend, that we would make the most of these quote-unquote holy weeks in a calendar, that there would be, that we would truly would be ushered into an encounter with the Lord. And so that's our prayer in this, so let's lean into that. This afternoon, House of Prayer session, we are going to be praying for the nation. But before we do the work of intercession, we always are intentional about starting with thanksgiving and worship, and so that's what we're going to do. We're going to wait on the Lord through thanksgiving and through worship. So let's turn our attention to the Lord, aligning our hearts with heavenly revelation of who God is, of what He is like. So God, we thank You for Your kindness towards us, for Your mercies that are new every day. And that means today, Your mercies are fresh. They're new, ever relevant. We thank You, God, for Your mercies, Your grace, Your all-sufficient grace. Just join with me and open up our mouths in thanksgiving to the Lord. Just say, thank You, God. Thank You. We come into Your presence with thanksgiving on our lips. Gratitude in our hearts. Children hear names this afternoon. Say thank You. Oh, we say thank You. We're going to wait on the Lord with gratitude, with worship, before we intercede.
Afternoon, Lord, I choose this day to be grateful. Say thank you, I'm telling you thank you. What an honor to give to you, Lord. What an wipe away every tear from our eyes. Oh, one day we'll see you, Lord. One day we'll see you face to face. One day we'll see you, oh. And on that day, he comes in glory to reveal the fullness of his reign. And our hearts will bow before the sound of Jesus' name. My victory, it's you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, it is one for me. Hallelujah, praise the Lord, hallelujah, Christ my victory. Death, where is your sting? Grave, where is your victory? Oh, you said it is finished. Oh, not it will be finished, but it is finished. Thank you, Lord. Oh, we have victory in you. blood, Lord, there's no other way. There's no other way. You gave your blood. You gave your blood. There's no other way. And I hear the Savior say, thy strength small child of weakness, watch and pray, find in me thine all in all. Oh, we want to find it in you, Jesus. There's nothing we can accomplish. Savior, say, thy strength indeed is small. Child of weakness, watch and pray. Find in me thine all in all. 'Cause Jesus paid it all to sin and left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. Wash me whiter than snow. Through your blood, through the blood of the Lamb. Oh, through the blood of the Lamb. Stand in him complete. Jesus died my soul to save, and my lips shall still repeat. And when before the throne I stand in him complete, Jesus died my soul to save, still repeat. Oh, forever we'll sing your praise, Lord. Oh, forever we'll sing of the goodness of our God, forever and ever. Oh, forever we'll sing your praise, Lord. Your
Thank you.
Session, can we just begin to pray for our nation, and specifically that this week our nation would see the Lord as the Lamb of God as the only hope. Let's begin to pray that this week truly would be a week of reviving in our nation. Hallelujah. We declare that over our nation, God. You as the Lamb of God. Not as just a good teacher or even a miracle worker only, but as the only answer, our only answer, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. God, may there be an authentic cry from within the church that says, look at the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, and the world would see, our nation would see. Many for the first time, God, they'd see through all the external things that oftentimes cloud people's vision of you. God, all the external makings of religion, the beautiful revelation of the Lamb of God would pierce through all of that. As you are exalted this week in our nation, may many come to the end of themselves as they recognize you as the only substitute. As the scapegoat. As the one who stood in our place. The ridicule, the mockery, and ultimately the final price of your death. God, may it ripple across this nation this week in power and anointing. May there be a returning back. A turning back this week. Be exalted over this nation. Lamb of God, meek. loving Lamb of God.
Yes.
Idolatry in our country, and let's start in the church, just an idolatry that needs to be turned from in the church towards the Lord, towards the Lamb of God is the only answer. I think this has been revealed, it's been being revealed as of late that there's an idolatry of human leaders, idolatry of celebrities, an idolatry of trying to find answers in human ways. And so let's pray right now. To intercede means to stand in the gap. So let's stand in the gap. Even if it's not your idolatry, we stand in the gap on behalf of our nation, and specifically the church in America, asking for his grace and his mercy. Lord, we repent on behalf of the church in America. We turn away from the idolatry of men who flaunt easy solutions and who say they have answers, but who are antichrist, who are against you, who carry no moral integrity upon their lives. God, we have been sold a bill of goods and we've lost our soul in the process. God, we turn away from that sort of idolatry and turn towards you, Christ the King, the Lamb of God. Church in America, turn away from these systems of men that put people on pedestals, crown people with glory that is only to be had by you. We turn from it. We exalt you as Lord. We exalt you as King. As the head. God, may there be a real humbling of the church in America. God, may our boast be the cross, where in America our boast is in our much, our affluence and our wealth and our riches and our assets. Lord, may our boast this week be in the cross. God, may we cling to the foolishness of the cross. Humble the church in America. It's a scary prayer, but God, it's my prayer. Would you pour out your grace? Would you soften the hearts of your people in this nation to exalt you as King, to step off the throne of our hearts. Have mercy, Lord. Have mercy, God. Love of the Lord. It's his love. love that's compelling us with faith. He's not done with our generation. He's not done with us. His hands are extended. He's looking for contrite people, humble people. In our nation, and it may seem like it's in a different trajectory, but the Lord has a way of tying it all together. So can we begin to pray for a restoration of family in our nation? So much has ravaged family in our country. Obviously, divorce and sexual morality, just to name a couple, but so many things have ravaged family in our nation, but it's the Lord's plan for the stability of family to be foundational to society. And so let's just begin to pray for a restoration of family, restoration of marriages. And these are big prayers, but let's believe in faith that these seeds will reap a harvest. These seeds of prayer mean something in the heavenlies. We're contributing our intercession in the heavenly places. Lord, we cling to the promise in Malachi 3 that you will turn the hearts of the fathers back to their children, the hearts of the children back to the fathers. So as we look around our generation, we see a fatherless generation. And we, as we compare that to Scripture, we say, God, this is not your will. So have your will in this nation and in our generation. May your will be done in our generation as it is in heaven. In accordance with the voice of the prophets, Lord. May there be a softening of hearts. May children be turned back to their parents. Specifically, I pray for the role of fathers in our nation. Raise up men of God who are familiar with the place on their knees, who are familiar with the prayer closet, men of God that truly walk in integrity and do not need positions or titles. Raise up men of God that have been freed from sexual morality and secret sins. God, that can truly lead a generation of young people where it's not the blind leading the blind, but saying, follow me as I follow Christ. Speak that upon men across our nation. Raise up godly fathers. God, men of your book. God, would you do it in our generation? Would you do it, Lord? I cry out, Lord, would you do it in our generation? God, men of God that lay down their lives for their wife. Men of God that are familiar with prayer for their kids. Men of God who put down the TV remote and pick up the Word of God. Men of God that are familiar with sacrificial love. Men with a testimony. God, that I speak that over our nation. Raise up men of God with a testimony, men you have snatched from the fire. men of God who've encountered you for themselves.
Every day, Lord, over our classmates, God, over people in the grocery store, over people we see when we're pumping gas, God, I thank you that you want freedom for them, Lord. There's an army break every chain, break every chain. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the cross. Imagine the people we see every day, and that the chains would just break off their lives. That we will hear those chains falling in Jesus' name. Oh, I hear those chains falling. I hear those chains falling. Chains falling. I hear those chains falling. 'Cause there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power. Every chain, break every chain. Oh. Idols stands in your presence, God. No idol stands in your presence. No idol stands in your presence. Thank you. Darkness now has ended. In the kingdom of light, in the kingdom of light, forever under your dominion. You're the king of my life, you're the king of my life. The work was finished. God, you poured out your life just to give us new life. And now on the lips of the forgiven, hear an anthem arise, 'cause Jesus, you're sing hallelujah. to the everlasting one. There is no higher name. Jesus, you reign above it all. Oh, yes, Lord, you reign. You reign, you reign. You sent the darkness running out of an empty grave. Seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You sent the darkness running out of an empty grave. Now seated alone in glory, enthroned on the highest praise. You sent the darkness running out of an empty grave. Now seated alone in thrown on the highest praise. As you sent the darkness running out of an empty grave, seated alone in glory and thrown on the highest praise. You sent the darkness running out of an empty grave, now seated alone in glory and thrown on the highest praise. The gift of faith, Jesus. The gift of faith, God. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, God. Thank you, Lord, that you sent the darkness running, God. Seated on your throne now, you are. Seated on your throne forever, forever, Jesus. Seated on the throne, the empty grave. fullness, God. You respond to hunger, God. Just feel that, Lord, like saying that. When we cry out to him, he just responds to hunger. Like people on their knees just crying out to him, he responds to it. Just think about, Lord, like that we'd be the ones, Lord, in this nation, God, just crying out for you, God. Crying out for you, God. Lord, we're crying out for you, God. Just right now, Lord, we just cry out to you, God. We're so hungry for you. We're so hungry for you, God. We want you, Jesus. We want you. We want you, Jesus. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Oh, are you hungry? Come on and ask. Come on. We're asking, Lord. Ask, seek, and knock. Yes, God. Thank you.
As we continue in this holy week, I just want us to read Mark 11, verse 11. This was after Jesus had entered Jerusalem, the triumphal entry. And he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. So he had already arrived Jerusalem. By the time the parade and all that was done, it was getting late. But he still wanted to get to the temple that evening. And so he went, he looked around at everything. Bible doesn't tell us what his reaction was or what his takeaway was from that. But I think we kind of know what happened, how he felt. What's important was the fact that he really wanted to do that. He really wanted to take a look at the temple. And so that's how the Holy Week began. The Bible tells us that the next day, he went to the temple. On his way to the temple, there was a fig tree that did not have any fruit. The Lord cursed it. And then he went to the temple like a man on a mission. He drove everyone that did not have any business out from the temple. Jesus, you know, the most of the Bible versions titles it, Jesus cleanses the temple. And if you can think about the significance of it, it was like Jesus was preparing the altar. Because the temple, I mean, there is no temple without the altar, really. It's just a building without the altar. So Jesus was preparing the altar. And if you read in the Old Testament, you find out that every time the altar is being prepared, it's because there's going to be a sacrifice. And so Jesus was preparing the altar for the sacrifice that was coming. It's been on my mind this Holy Week, the theme of preparation. Jesus is preparing. Each day in this Holy Week had its significance. He was preparing as he is on his way towards the cross. But that was for Jesus. He was preparing for his death. What about us? What are we? What is it for us that we are preparing for? It's not Friday. It's the resurrection morning. For us, right here, we are preparing for resurrection morning. When we get to step into that covenant that God created, established in the Garden of Eden, when we get to become who we were meant to be, that's what resurrection is about. And that is a preparation for us. And so I want us to pray right now, because we will not get to the resurrection without the altar being prepared. And the Bible says that we are the temple of the Holy Ghost. And that altar is our heart. And I want you right now to just believe with God today that this Easter will not just be a celebration or a sacrament or whatever it is. It won't just be a church event, but it will be like the Lord desired it to be, a transformation. Transformation from us being people in need of a sacrifice to becoming co-heirs with Jesus. That's what resurrection is about. We step into that new covenant. we have access to that power that raised Jesus from the dead. That power is what brings transformation. It's what sustains transformation. And that is the power that God wanted us to have in the Garden of Eden. So I just want you to just pray for yourself. Ask the Lord. Present yourself before the Lord. Present yourself before the Lord. Get rid of every dead wood, every cold wood, every debris, everything, the altar of our heart right now, whatever it is that should not be there, present it, give it up right now. Let's ask for God's mercy. Let's ask for the cleansing of the blood of Jesus. Everything that hinders us, everything that has become an idol in our lives, everything that catches our attention, let's ask God to forgive us. Let's ask the Lord to get rid of it in our lives. We are preparing our hearts before you, O God, as an altar to you, Lord, the living God. We give up every distraction, Jehovah. We give up every pride of life, every lust of the flesh, every lust of the eyes. Lord, we give it up right now. Everything, Jehovah, that you have not made or designed for us, Lord, we give it up right now. We ask for your cleansing power. Like you cleanse the temple, Lord, we are the temple this moment. We are asking that you cleanse us. Make us whole, Lord. Wash us by the blood of Jesus and sanctify us. That, Lord, this resurrection morning, that we will experience that transformation that you desired for us. That we will step into that new covenant. That we will have access, Lord, to that power that raised Jesus from the dead. Now, this was Holy Monday. Holy Tuesday, Jesus was at Mount of Olives, according to the Mark translation, and he began to talk to his disciples about the end times. In Mark 13, Jesus kept using the word, be watchful, be watchful, be watchful. Jesus was looking beyond his death and resurrection. He was seeing us. Jesus, in Mark 13, was seeing you and I. He was seeing the persecution that we are going to endure. He was seeing the world as chaotic as it is, nations against nations, father against son. Jesus saw that on Holy Tuesday. That was part of the preparation. Be watchful was the word. Be watchful. Do not be afraid for what to speak. Because this gospel is going to be preached in all the nations. That was the message. The reason why there is so much chaos in the world is because the enemy is trying to stop the gospel from being preached. That is the whole purpose for all of these things. And Jesus saw beyond that. And I want us right now, you know, once the altar is prepared, it becomes easier to be watchful because there is no more distraction. You are able to have a single focus on the purpose. And that purpose, at the end of everything, the whole purpose is that the gospel will be preached. And I want us to pray right now for missionaries around the world. And of course, we are missionaries too. I want us to pray that nothing, that in all these nations, the Bible says that the church is marching on and the gates of Hades will not be able to prevail against it. And so I want us to just pray for missionaries wherever they are in the world, that the Lord's hand of protection will be upon them, that God will protect them from every political instability, that God will protect them from every mob that does not want to hear the gospel of Christ, that God will protect them from every demon-possessed girl that tries to distract or tries to undermine integrity. Right now, let's pray for this. There is a move of the enemy to undermine the integrity of God's children, of men and women of God around the world. I want us to pray right now that the fire of God will destroy every such move, that God will shield and protect his people. We see it in the news that God will expose every such agenda. And that was Holy Tuesday. Tomorrow, Judas will agree to betray Jesus. And this becomes a prayer that we need to pray for ourselves. When we have our own personal agenda, when we have our own personal understanding about what God is doing, sometimes it can get in the way. Sometimes it can get in the way. That God would keep us from pride. That God would keep us from every pride and every association that does not bring glory to him. Every pursuit in our lives that does not reflect the purpose of God, the mission of God, that the Lord would disconnect us from it. On Holy Thursday, Jesus began by saying, "I have longed to spend this day with you." The Last Supper. Jesus gave them the template, what the new covenant was going to be about. The Last Supper. Do this in remembrance of me. I keep thinking that the early church, when they were breaking bread, they were actually practicing the Last Supper. It wasn't just in remembrance, but it was their new reality. This is our life, every day with Jesus. Love, that everlasting pursuit of you and I, led him to the cross. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, that you never stopped pursuing us. We thank thank you, Jehovah, that you were okay just leaving the 99 to go after us. We thank you for that everlasting love. Because of your everlasting love, Lord, we rise with you on resurrection morning. Because of your everlasting love, Lord, we step into the new covenant on resurrection morning with you. May there be a transformation in our lives this year, oh God. May you usher us into a new chapter than we have ever seen or experienced before. God, may we walk in that power that raised you from the dead. Because, Lord, our neighborhoods, our nation is earnestly yearning, desiring for the manifestation of the sons and daughters of God. That, Lord, we will meet that need, that longing, Jehovah, shall cease because we step out in the power of the Holy Ghost and by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for this moment. We magnify you, Lord. There is no one like you. Continue, Lord, this work that you have started in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.